Hello YouTube, my name is Hero and today we're going to be discussing how to reach level 60 in Black Desert Online. This guide will be a follow-up guide to my previous guide, How to Reach Level 50, so I recommend watching that guide first. With that being said, let's begin the guide. The first thing I want to do is congratulate you for reaching level 50. Now that you're level 50, you are officially out of the tutorial stage of BDO, but you still have a long way to go. From now on, the game will be a bit more difficult, experience gain will start to get slower, mobs will start to hit harder, and players are free to attempt to kill you now if you're outside of safe zones. Welcome to Black Desert. There are a few options available to you on what to do next. All of these options can be classified under two categories, the Tortoise Way and the Hare Way. The Tortoise Way will be much slower, but get you further ahead in the end, and the Hare Way will level you faster, but still leave you a little behind in certain areas. In Black Desert, there are many things that progress your character. Passive silver via energy uses and contribution point allocation is vital to late game monetary sustainability, for example. You will also need skill points, which you will gain a lot more if you go the Tortoise Way. However, in my opinion, it should be your goal to reach level 56 as fast as humanly possible, as that is when you unlock your awakening. So for this guide, we're going to stick with the Hare way of doing things. I'm sure that's what most of you want, but if you're interested in taking things slowly, I recommend you do. Like I said, it'll get you further ahead in the long run. You can search for YouTube and the rest of the internet for guides on building passive income, gaining skill points, and increasing the worth of your character's longevity in general. Alright, so let's begin with the Hare way. The moment you hit level 50, your next goal should be level 56. You have many options to get to level 56, but I'm going to focus on the best three overall choices. The first choice is to stay at Catfish a little longer. These guys still provide a decent experience even at level 50. They also provide good silver and blackstone drops. I'd say stay here until about level 52. The second choice is to leave Catfish right away and head to better grind spots, but this all depends on your current AP. AP will be a factor from now on where you go. At level 50, if you manage to get 80 AP or below, I recommend you go to Calpheon Shrine, which is located here. This will give you a good amount of EXP until around level 53 at a higher rate than Catfish. If you are above 80 AP, then you are ready to enter the next region known as Media. Media monsters are a bit stronger than you're used to, so be prepared for that. Once in Media, there are two spots I would recommend. One is Mains, located here. And the other is Helms, located here. Both provide great money and also great EXP. You want to stay at these places until level 53 to 54. Once you're at level 53 or 54, you are ready to go to either of the next two places. Elric Shrine if you want to go alone, and Sawson Garrison if you can find a group. Sawson Garrison is the best experience gain you can get in Media, and you will come here eventually no matter what. This place can last you a very long time. Some even stay here until level 60 and beyond due to reasons I will explain later. For now, let's just focus on hitting level 56 for your awakening. Before grinding at Sosin, you must invest contribution points in a storage chest. You can get this for 10 contribution points at any major town's warehouse manager. This storage chest allows you to access the nearest town's storage, which you will need because the loots you get from Sawson Garrison will weigh you down quite a bit. You will also need a residence in order to place the storage chest, so you're going to get one in Kusha, which is right next to Sosin. You also want to take your horse and leave it here. Whenever your horse gets full on storage, bring it back to Kusha and store your items in the storage chest, then continue grinding. Your third choice for leveling after you hit level 50 is to join a guild. Now I know many of you may be wondering how joining a guild helps you level. Well, on paper it doesn't, but there are plenty of guilds with members who are willing to power level new recruits, and if you just be patient, you can easily find guild recruitment messages looking for pretty much anyone to join. When you ask the recruiter for more information, just ask if they are willing to help new players with leveling. Most likely they will say yes, and once you join their guild, you can try to find a group of players to go with you to Sawson at 50. If you find a group to take you, when you get there, I recommend you focus on looting rather than killing mobs, as your damage will not be much help to the group at this point. Don't worry, many people enjoy when people loot for them as Saucens because there's just so much loot and the pets can't pick it all up. The money you collect here will be much more beneficial to you, and you can use it to buy gear from the auction house to help you level faster. This strategy will level you extremely fast compared to other strategies, but be warned, you will lack skill points. Pro tip. Once you hit level 55, you unlock a quest called Combat Advancement. You can find it in this guy here at Summer Outpost. This quest will give you 40% of level 55 when you turn it in, and you'll get a ton of experience just for doing it. It is a long quest chain, but it's worth your time in my opinion. Check it out if grinding is getting a little too slow. Alright, so you reached level 56 and unlocked your awakening. Congratulations, you have officially reached the soft cap for BDO. Your journey will be much tougher now, and once again you have options. You can either stay at Saucen and start killing more efficiently, or you can head to Pirate Island, which gives much more EXP than Saucen, but at a huge cost. For starters, let's say you decide to stay at Saucen. There are four rotations I would like to show you that I find the best. Main rotation. Figure 8 is only recommended if you're in a party and are just clearing way too fast. All of the others are viable choices and get you great EXP and silver. If you ever want more, Pirate Island gives the best solo experience in the game currently. However, it comes with a few catches. One, it's so far from everything else that you can't help your guild in PvP without a long boat ride back, and you can't go to world bosses unless you have an alternate character to hop on. Number two, once you're out there, to make it efficient, you have to stay out there as long as possible. You don't want to be taking boat rides back and forth. And number three, it has the most highly contested spots in the game. You must expect PvP when you come here. Alright, so first things first, before heading to Pirates, you're going to want to stack up on a few things. First thing is milk tea. Grab a bunch. Next thing is experience elixirs. Buy as many as your bank allows, then go to the material item vendor and buy these two items. Blue reagent and Oz tears. Press Ale and Simple Alchemy. For every 3 normal experience elixirs and 1 blue reagent, you can make 1 super experience elixir, which gives 15% EXP instead of 10%. Once you have 2 super experience elixirs, you can turn them into a party elixir, which will apply to your whole party and give you an EXP buff that lasts longer. Make as many of these as you can. You also want to stack up on other foods like Night Combat Ration, Serendia Specials, King of Jungle Hamburg, etc. Lastly, try to free up as much inventory space as possible. You will get a lot of loot here. Also, try to get as much AP as you can before setting sail. More AP is better EXP. Whoa!
Let's get it!
Now, once you've got everything and your boat, the last thing you must bring is your horse. Your horse will allow you to stay at Pirates for a very long time. This is because Pirates drop a turn-in item called bandanas. These can be turned in on an island east of Pirate Island known as Lima Island. If you don't have your horse, you will be overweight in no time. You will also pick up coins. These coins are best stored in your boat. Your boat has carry limit though, so you won't be able to put them in there forever, and if you were to put bandits in it as well, it just wouldn't work. Remember that if your horse dies, you are in some serious trouble, and you can't revive it out here, so make sure you keep it safe. Whistle your horse on your boat and head out. Now once you make it to Pirate Island, the very first thing you should do is bring your horse here. This is a safe zone and no one can hurt it here. The second thing you want to do is put your boat inside of the wharf to ensure its safety as well. And now you're ready to grind. There are a lot of options here, but we're going to focus on the best three from least to greatest. The number three best experience in Pirates is called the main route. This will be the route that most parties do and will provide you with great experience and a bit more protection than usual. Most people won't try to contest the group at this area, but it can happen. This spot is great if you're new to Pirates and just want some chill EXP and money. Number two best experience is solo or duo grinding this rotation here. There are tons of mobs for you to pick from and they provide tons of EXP. Be warned that these mobs hit hard and you must have decent AP to grind here effectively. PvP is also very high here. And the absolute number one spot for EXP in the game is this rotation here. It's usually called the jungle rotation and is found by following this route. The mob density here is insane, and the EXP is abnormally high. You can come here solo, duo, even a full group if you all have low AP. You will level up here so fast. I got my character from 56 to 58 in 3 days leveling here. It's simply the best experience in the game, and I got to level 60 in no time at this very spot. Be warned, this is the highest contested area in the game. All of the strongest players come here. I recommend you bring a group with you if you are low gear or new to PvP. You can pretty much guarantee a fight if you grind here. Following this guide will help you get to level 60 as fast as possible, but like I said, the tortoise will still be ahead of you in other areas. After level 60, the experience you gain will drop dramatically, and so dramatically that it's not even funny, and the money made getting to level 60 won't last you forever. At this point, I highly suggest you go back to the mainland and focus on other things besides grinding. But if you insist on continuing grinding, you can. You crazy fuck.